Greetings, sir and sirettes, and welcome back to From the Depths with me, Lathrix, and of course, welcome back to the Shriven version 2 currently in the sandbox. So in today's episode, our main goal is to make the Shriven a little bit more effective. In the previous video, it didn't do terribly, but it certainly wasn't worth the extreme material cost it requires to keep these lasers going, and there were two reasons for it. The first reason is the lovely continuous lasers. Although they are incredibly effective, if they are not able to hit the same spot on the enemy craft over a prolonged period of time, they don't really do anything, and this is because of the fact that if you have a pulse laser around, well, between 0.5 and 2 seconds-ish of the laser is charging up and then it fires, so it's the equivalent of having those seconds on one location. When you have a continuous laser, it hits 40 times per second, so even if you're moving only slightly, you end up hitting a very large area. And of course, the vehicle itself is constantly moving, and the lasers are as well. Also, don't trust the 0.5 and 2. That was from a very long time ago. I'm not quite sure how fast the pulse laser fires anymore, but you get the general idea. It still holds true. The second thing we need to upgrade, and this was mentioned by a lot of people, and it's something I completely derped up with. The armor penetration we need is not 10. It's not 10 at all. It's 20, 21, or 22, depending on the percentage you're going for with regular metal. The general rule is go for double the armor value, not actually the armor value itself. I know this off by heart. It's why my armor penetrating rounds on all of my vehicles have an AP minimum of 22. But I just completely forgot. It's one of those little things in From the Depths where it's not immediately obvious when you're just looking at numbers. You see a metal block, you see it has an armor value of 10, you would assume that the armor penetration would also need to be 10, but that is not the case, which means our lasers were not doing full damage against even metal, and against heavy armor, they were doing pretty much nothing. So what I'm going to do is swap them over back to the pulse version, and I'm going to up their armor penetration back to at least 20. I also need to re-add the mainframe, apparently, because I just looked at that last bit of footage, and I don't know why, but the save of this vehicle didn't have a mainframe, so the weapon wasn't connected. Little bit odd. Don't know really how that happened. Armor penetration is now set to 23, because that's just how it ended up, and we now have the slowest version of the pulse laser. Each shot should do around about 6,000 damage. Oh, it is in fact AI dead, I'm just not ignoring salvage. Okay, so that first shot did indeed kill the old school Shriven, just like the previous version did, so let's tack something a little bit more heavily armored. Not heavy armor itself, but something which should hopefully take a couple more hits. Something like, let's say, the Bloodletter. It should still be able to kill this fairly easy, but it should be a bit more of a challenge than the old Shriven. The old Shriven was never designed to really take a hit. That's probably going to fall to the floor since it's got steam engines, which don't have material in them by default. Yep, AI dead yet again. That was... yep, okay. Okay, pulse version seems to be a lot better than the continuous laser version. How about a normal enemy, one of not my designs? The difference between that and before we added the extra armor penetration is ridiculous. Okay, AP is very, 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 very important for continuous lasers. Today, children, we have learned a lesson. If you want to shoot metal, make sure you can damage metal. What? Weapons only. That was faster than expected. I don't know if that's good building or bad building on my part. Is that a really good laser? Or do you have, like, no defense? Maybe both. It may be hideous, but the laser has gone from 0.3 in accuracy to 0.18. Will that make any real difference at longer ranges? I would say yes. It's still hideously inaccurate, but it's at least hitting in the same kind of area now. Beforehand, at this range, it was pretty much nullified. Perhaps there is some hope for the continuous laser after all, if we make it look like this. Oh, Shriven, I'm so sorry what I'm doing to you, mate. Okay, now that was quite surprising. The continuous laser is definitely doing better versus heavy armor than the pulse laser is, at least at quite short ranges. So maybe the continuous laser really, really does have something to offer. It's just a matter of learning how to build one when you're so used to building the pulse laser. I am also tempted to try and up the armor penetration again of this thing, but I would start to have to sacrifice a little bit of damage. We also need stronger engines, which is unbelievable considering we're already outputting 15,000 engine power. This thing is just basically one huge engine and laser weapon, which is just about floating by the Dark God's wills. Well then. Okay, that was the final test. The Shriven is going to continue to be a continuous laser. It is remarkably powerful now, actually bordering on one of the strongest lasers I've ever built, and it's going to absolutely melt regular metal. And this time I can be completely correct about that because I've got the armor penetration correct. I've also added some more thrusters to the top, which makes it more balanced and less likely to flip over if it takes a little bit of damage, and it even has a little bit of extra engine power because I've upped the amount of energy storage. It's very frail, but now at medium range and short range, it's more accurate, more powerful, and it can do very, very well against regular metal. It will, of course, also do a little bit better against heavy armor, but that's never going to be a goal of mine, because in this game of limited volume, it's very difficult to have true anti-armor weaponry. Or, well, at least anti-armor weaponry against heavy armor. We could go with a railgun, but that is so easily countered by shields, it's not really worth it just yet. Perhaps in the future against the Onyx Watch. So with that, let's get into the campaign, do a few battles, and see how it does. I've been here now for over 2 hours, and honestly, I'm a bit bored of messing around with one tank. Back in the campaign, all of the Shriven have been updated to the new version, the version 2.5, and I'm currently working on the Krull very briefly before we get attacked by the Onyx Watch again, because at the moment we don't need the refinery in the back section here, so instead, I've just added a little armored section for a tiny bit of added ammunition. This way we should be able to fire a little bit faster once we've fired all the missiles. They should reload a little bit quicker, so the Krull can do a bit more damage, since right now, it's not actually needed for fuel at all. The Bloodletter is steam powered, the Shriven is steam powered, the new version of the Angron is going to be steam powered, both the Particle Cannon version and the regular cannon version. So we don't really need it for any kind of fuel refinery. So, more missiles, more ammunition, more happiness. Since fighting the Onyx Watch has been so lucrative, I'm now adding a single Shriven to the Northern Group. Once that's fully repaired, we're going to start attacking the tiles the Onyx Watch has recently claimed for their own. If we can push them back, these three tiles, we should have a clear path to find their resource zones. And as soon as we take out at least one resource zone, they are going to be massively crippled. The Onyx Watch are now attacking us, and sadly, I started the fight a little bit early, so we're quite far away from the enemy. I'm actually hoping this will probably give us an advantage. Since we are using advanced cannons, missiles, and lasers, the enemies tend to use cram cannons, which are very hard to hit at very long ranges. The enemy are made up of Onagers, if that's how you pronounce that, and Fletchers, two new enemy types. Both of them are near 3,000 volume and around about 30,000 material. Well, 35,000 for the Fletcher, 26,000 for the Onager. So quite expensive, quite big. Let's kill them. Here's hoping that the new version of the Shriven will get the job done well. Oh dear, I spawned into the wrong location when I tried to make the land spawn in, so a lot of water around here, which I really hope doesn't give us an unfair advantage, or perhaps a disadvantage, since half of our craft are indeed over the water. So which one of you is which? You are the Onager, you are the Fletcher. The Fletcher is really adorable. I would have never thought that was near 3,000 volume. That is really, really cute. Okay, begin the battle. The laser is already hitting the target, doing some minor internal damage. One of the Bloodletters has just started firing on the side, and the enemy is airborne because of it. The water finally goes away. Well, at long ranges, the laser isn't doing too much, at least in comparison to the Bloodletters. The missiles haven't even been fired yet. Oh no, they have now been fired. The Bloodletter's cannon still not disappointing in the slightest. The laser is doing better, now it's getting closer. Definitely not a long range weapon though. Breaking off the side and then swapping targets. Oh, I think it may have caused AI death before swapping. So well done to the laser, you get your first kill. The problem is it does seem to target the same targets the Bloodletter does, so it's hard to tell what the Shriven is doing and what the Bloodletters are doing. The missiles have finally arrived. Ooh. Seems like one of the Bloodletters have taken some damage and it's caused it to flip over. That's two damage, Shriven. You're meant to be ignoring salvage. Another massacre against the Onyx Watch. Now, since the last video, I did check up, and it turns out the Onyx Watch is considered one of the easier factions in this game. The White Flyers, on the other hand, are considered one of the more difficult. You have a friend or foe. Don't even dare attack one of my allies. Thank you. I wonder why they all swerved this way. They clearly were not going after the Bloodletters, if I can say the sodding sentence, but they all turned the same way. A little bit curious. The Bloodletter has repaired itself. Remember when we were fighting against the Steel Empire, and I kept on saying, if we take too long to kill these guys, all the other factions will be able to bulk up their forces so much they will be able to attack us in very high number, because of course we are in 2x difficulty in terms of enemy ramp-up factor. Well, this is the type of fight I was talking about. So, we have a singular Chaos, a Ravager, a Beholder, a Wrecker, a Priest, a Priest, a Reaver, another Reaver, Forsaken, Forsaken, and a Reaver. The Beholder here is bigger than the Chaos. It seems to be more heavily armored than the Chaos. It seems to be more heavily shielded than the Chaos. It also may be a hovercraft based on a few things we've seen, although with those wheels, maybe not. For a second, it looked like it perhaps had a PID system, but I don't think that's the case. Well, good luck, guys. I don't believe in you in the slightest. Sorry for the very weird glitchy moment there. Apparently the crawl just got threw into the air because of the laggy land. Ah, they're all going after the bloodletter again. Oh no. The beholder has laser defense. Yeah, it has a smoke defense. That's absolutely terrible for us. Thankfully, a load of the bloodletter shots are getting through and doing some damage to the beholder. Nowhere near enough, though. That's doing hardly anything. One of the Shriven have just killed the other one. Fantastic. Just what I wanted to see. The missiles are going for the Wrecker and just about missing. Not quite agile enough. Come on. All we need is a couple of shots on the back and that thing will stop moving. There we are. The Wrecker is down. The Bloodletter is now being caught up by the Chaos. And dodging. Wow. Well done, Bloodletter. Although its weapon systems are down, so... Oh, those slow motion missiles, though. A couple of the enemies are now classed as 2 damaged. I think that may be from the Shriven. It's hard to tell how dark it's getting, and the Bloodletter is being rammed from behind. But thankfully, that just detonated. Oh no, it was the Bloodletter that detonated. I do apologize. The laser is doing pretty well from the Shriven, although only one is currently functioning because it killed its ally. This is what happens when you theme your army around Khorne the Blood God. I lied. I lied again. The other Shriven is still up. It's doing so much better than the old version. It's... Wow, look at that. Thank you, Shriven. Keep on going. Were those EMP shells? The Shriven is trying its best against the Beholder, but the smoke is now back up. No, those are kinetic. No, they are EMP shells. Okay, that's actually really good against the Shriven. The Chaos was defeated as... No, no, there's the Chaos. The Chaos was defeated. Yeah. Of course that's going to happen. A bit optimistic there on my part. Missiles coming from the Krull. The extra ammo is really helping. The amount of damage the Krulls are now able to do. The enemy is AI dead. We could have captured it, but we were nowhere near. And before someone says, why don't you just make a capturing vehicle? Because the capturing vehicle would die during the battle early on. It would be impossible to defend and a waste of resources for the most part. Seriously though, the Chaos survived better than the Beholder. The Chaos is such a good vehicle. No, the Shriven's doing so well, and EMP followed by just missing with the melee, but either way, killing it. No, the Shriven's still going. Shriven, stop making me think you're dead. The new version of the Shriven is infinitely better than the old version. Not doing too badly. Massive damage on the outside, though. You've got that at such a bad angle, you're not actually damaging it. Okay, that's just mean. But yeah, you're not damaging that. Wait, is that Shriven still firing? The Shriven oh, wow, look at that. Oh, you've got to give respect to this brave, brave Shriven, just trying its hardest, being attacked by a Chaos, still shooting inside of it. And if the aim point selection is still working, it was probably going for something vulnerable. Oh no, it's got out from underneath, and there we go, the Chaos slicing right through it. The other Shriven is back online. They do have a lot of repair bots. They have 35 repair bots each, so in terms of repairs, they're very good. However, we are now out of materials. Long range, the Shriven's laser isn't doing too much. Missiles incoming from the Krull are the only thing we may win by. We do have 2 Krull still online, so we're not completely out of it yet. There is one other enemy nearby, which is essentially dead. I think it's okay for me to capture that. In the sake of fairness, I think we can kill that thing. I'm not going to capture the Chaos unless it becomes AI dead, however, because that would just be really unfair. No, go for the Chaos! Why have you swapped targets? Look at that thing about to ram you! Well, just about go underneath you. Oh, that missile taking out half of its propulsion. Ah, the Shriven's now upside down, and it's doing that weird bug with the graphical glitch. Missiles trying their hardest. Seriously, the Chaos is amazing. So much self-repair, so much armor, so many shields. Not that really matters too much against missiles and lasers, but even so. A load of respect for whoever made the Chaos. That is easily one of the best vehicles I've ever seen. Hello. Okay, you're now mine. I'm not going to repair you though, so I don't want the extra cost. Right now the materials need to be given to the Krull. Receiving. I mean, I guess I could repair you. I could force a repair. No, you are too damaged. Okay, fair enough. Even if I was repairing, it would eventually have died. Once again, raining, of course, because who wants to see battles in this game? Oh, a very large explosion on the back section of the Chaos. The missiles from the Krull are just not good enough. They cannot pierce that much armor. So what I'm going to do very quickly is just swap one of these for an extra frag. There we are. All of you are now fragment. You are now fragment as well. These are now shorter range, but will do more damage. Uh-oh, Chaos right behind you. Krull, fire your last volley. Oh, it's gone. As soon as the Chaos reaches the Krull, it is just over with. Okay, we're on the second Krull. Swapping over now to more fragments as well. I don't deem this as particularly cheesy. I am trying to avoid, you know, actually building whilst we do this, but swapping out ammunition doesn't seem anywhere near as bad. I mean, we're on a vehicle that can fabricate missiles out of just raw material. I think it's okay. One missile there, sliding and hitting the other. Oh, that Krull is still alive. Look, there's the AI in the middle. All the walls around it have been destroyed. Actually pretty good on our part, though, because that means there is a distraction for the Chaos. Hopefully we'll go for that Krull rather than the functional one which is still shooting missiles. Even with the extra warhead, it's just doing nothing to this thing. Only the bloodletters and the lasers seem to be able to get through. Mostly the bloodletters. Oh, its melee thing's broken though. Pretty good for us. It seems to get a bit stuck now when it hits the target. It still kills the target, but... Oh, why is that Krull so close? It should be trying to run away. In fact, it is now turning away. It's because it caught up so quickly. I no longer have manual controls on the Krull. If I did, I could easily try to duck out of the way, but I feel like this is going to be another victory for the Chaos. And, yep, there it goes. Oh, once again, though, in quite a bad position. If these missiles can turn around, they may be able to still fight. I'm not hopeful, but there's a chance. Yeah, not really too hopeful here. However, like I was saying earlier, I don't mind swapping out ammunition, so... That's ridiculously short range now, but that doesn't really matter since the enemy is underneath us. The missiles should now be very, very agile. And they are. Again, I could jump off and capture, but that is just... I cannot do that. It's just so cheesy. And the Krull breaks free, which isn't actually a good thing. We didn't really want that. What we would really like is for the Krull to have stayed where it was then. It wasn't taking damage. Such a ridiculously long battle. In the future, I will edit these down, but right now, I would like to just showcase how long they're actually taking, so I do apologize for that. Oh no, it's guns back online. The other Krull is still alive? How do you keep on living? Repair. Just repair bots. So many of them on the Krull and the Shriven. The missiles might be a bit too short range now. May have to swap them back over. Okay, we're going to go for full on... No, I can't swap that one, but I can swap that one. So you become fuel. You become another fragment. Maybe I should swap fragments for something else. Honestly, at this point, they're clearly not working. But even so. So, fuel. What I should have done really is save the weapon and swap it over that way. But that takes too much time in my head, even though this is obviously taking far too much time as well. Come on, Krull! Beat the Chaos! It does so little! How are you surviving these? They are very strong missiles. We've seen them just crush other enemies. And the Chaos is behind again, thankfully getting stuck again. Seems like the cannon is offline along with some other components. What I would love to see offline is its engine. Did I just mess up these? I shouldn't have. Look at all of those repair bots. So many. There's all of those on top, then there's loads on the inside as well. You think you can self-repair well? Well, so can I. Really? Okay, so I've probably started skipping now. This is about 4 minutes later. Well, we've broke through a lot at the back there. If we can get a missile in... There's the engine. If we can get one missile to land there, I think we may have a chance. Watching it live. It's not able to keep up anymore. I think we've damaged enough wheels that the crawl is now the same speed as the Chaos. It's still terrifying. No, it is a little bit faster. It's still terrifying, but seeing the missiles hit, at least it's giving me a bit of hope. Not really wanted that one to hit there, honestly. Should be hitting at the back more. There! Close! Really close! Oh! Damaged in friendly territory! It's losing! It's losing! Okay, so, pause time! Now I think capturing is fine. Pause. Hello. This is about to detonate. The enemy Chaos has lost versus the final Krull, and only just about. Oh, there's two Krulls. Stop doing that to me. I keep on thinking there's only one, but then the other one pops up out of nowhere every time. Whoa, those are huge steam engines. No wonder. Steam engines and fuel engines. This thing's just a box of engines and power. There's the cannon. So much going on here. But where would the AI be? I have no idea. There's some surge protectors at the top. Ah, in that giant lump of heavy metal. There's no chance I'm getting through that in zero. Yeah, okay. Never mind. We can't capture the Chaos. Goodbye, sir. I'm still on there in case it randomly destroys the AI first, but no. There it goes. The Chaos has been destroyed. Sorry, the game just froze there, but there we are. The Chaos has finally been defeated, and really showcasing that missiles are not that powerful. Even with three or four warheads, it's more a matter of their guaranteed damage. The Shriven are definitely improved, still need a bit of work, but very happy with them in comparison to the last fight. Yes. We at some point stole the Priest. Oh yes, we did. Okay, I will repair the Priest and have a look how it's built so we can design things similar in the future. And I will just repair all of our forces down here, although they are going to have to go back to base, as they are out of resource. Well, with that, I am going to call the episode. Quite an action-packed one in terms of battles, but not really much happening in terms of sheer progress. In the next video, we are going to try to be more aggressive against the Onyx Watch. I'm going to perhaps start work on the new Angron, and now we have the Shriven operational, less technical stuff at the start of the video. So more battles, and I promise I will edit them better. I know in this one, even before starting editing, it's going to be quite a long, drawn-out set of battles. In the future, I will try to streamline them a little bit. So, thank you for watching. If you have enjoyed, then of course, likes, favourites, shares, comments, all that good stuff helps out me, helps out the channel, and most importantly, shows that From the Depths is a series you wish to see continued in the future. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.